Welcome to Books of the Month, and I'm your host, Dr. Larry Carnes, and we're so excited. We have a very special guest with us today. She's going to be sharing with us from a very powerful, powerful book that she's written, The Strength of the Nation. She's going to be giving us some insights, and we're going to be so excited to get in that. Ms. Planter, how are you today?
I'm doing wonderful. Thank you.
I tell you, your smile is just lighting up the entire place. We're just thankful to God for that. Why don't you take the time and introduce yourself to our audience and tell them a little bit about yourself and then introduce this great book.
Okay. So I came to the United States in 1970 when I met my husband in Italy. I was a school teacher, and then we met, we winked at each other, and that's the rest is history with a wink. He winked at me and I winked back. And so then 2 years later, we were married. And so when I came to the United States, my husband sent me to school over here to get a degree in the United States, and I got me a degree in political science. Why did I want to get? Yeah, why? Because I wanted to know what makes America so great. And so I thought political science is what I want to do. I know about education, but now I want to know something different.
Yeah.
And then I started to write, writing The Angel of the Lord. I prayed because I was in a convent for 7 years with nuns in Italy to get my degree in education. So it was a boarding school. And so religion is a great part of my life. And so I'm putting religion and religion and politics together, and I got something so wonderful that I want to share with everybody else. And
that's powerful.
The strength of the nation.
That's a beautiful cover. Now, so you said that you came to America in 1970.
Yes.
And so you came to America, and then you went to school and, you know, political science. Now, political science is challenging for anyone. And so, but you wanted to know about what makes America great.
Yes.
And you also wanted to have some interest in the government. How does the government work?
That's right. Yes. I wanted to know.
Yes. So speak to us about, share with our audience.
Yes.
Why this hunger to realize what makes America great, and then how you connect that with the ministry and the gospel in your background?
Yes, that's right. So America is known throughout the entire world, is known for its generosity, and it's known for its good government structure. And that's what I wanted to learn, the good government structure and all the political aspects. And so when President Trump came on the political scene, that he wanted to make America great and strong, and I read that paragraph in my book, The Angel of the Lord, and so I prayed, and then I had new visions, and so that's why I wrote this book. I had these visions at night, how to achieve what we needed to achieve to get America back on track. And so, my dear friends, and my dear doctor, I envisioned that the President Biden, doing what he is doing, he is allowing us to go a rock bottom. So, I'm going to shut my telephone off. So we were here, and then a little bit at a time, America gave, it's generous. America is generous. And so America gave and gave. And now with President Biden, America has reached the rock bottom. And now the only place to go is to go up. There. Now the only place is to go is to go up. We reached the rock bottom, and this allows us to start going up again.
No, okay. So now, you know, now America has been known as a, in my world travel.
Yes.
The world looks to America to be some type of a messiah for the world.
Yes.
Now, I tell people in my travel, America isn't God. America isn't the messiah for the world. So when you talk about America and America being generous and America giving, is it are you of the opinion that because America gives, that it's causing us to go to the rock bottom?
Yes.
But that's what America has been known for forever. So talk to us about that.
So it looks like now, it looks like that we are being foolish. Everyone says, what is going on with our government, with President Biden? He's doing this, he's doing that. So I hear people saying, this is crazy. But that is our qualification for God to give us a new assignment.
Mm.
It's a new assignment for America to go back up again. And this new assignment is that we are going to get President Trump back onto White House because he has shown us that he has qualified us to bring America up again. Right now, there is no one that can substitute him. But then after him, I hope that other people pick up after him. But right now, we thank President Biden that has allowed us to reach this top rock bottom and so that we qualify for our new assignment. So I was reading the Bible, and when Moses found that the Jewish people didn't want to listen to him, he said to them, I will provoke you by a people that are not yet people, and by a foolish nation, you see that word foolish? And by a foolish nation, I will anger you. That foolish nation, President Biden qualified us to become foolish. But why are we foolish? Because we gave and gave and gave, and now we can't give anymore. And now we want to become a socialist, and we want to become a communist, and so. But it seems like we don't know what we're doing, but God knows.
Now, when you make those statements, when we look at Moses, remember that the children of Israel went into captivity because they disobeyed God.
Yes.
They were not obedient to what God's instructions were.
That's right. Yes.
Now, but so let's look from this perspective.
So, yes.
When
they killed Jesus, see, they killed Jesus, and they don't... Jesus was for God. Jesus was not against God. But they did not accept it. They killed him. And so God is telling them again, I will provoke you to jealousy by a people that are not yet people. But who are these people? It's us. Look in our Declaration of Independence. We the people. You see, we don't know what we're doing. God knows what He's doing.
Okay, now let's look at this. Now, remember, when we talk about America and America giving, remember that Jesus was always giving.
That's right.
So now, would that imply that America does give?
Yes.
Jesus was always giving because remember, Jesus said, when you've done it to the least of them, you've done it to me.
So you give, and that's what qualifies us as a giver. You see, we have not reached this top bottom because we were selfish. We have reached the top bottom because we were giving and giving and giving. And now we are at the point that God is going to make us a prototype of the kingdom of God to help the Jewish people. See, the Jewish people are very important people. The most important people of the world are the Jewish people. They are the ones who gave us the Bible. They are the ones who gave us Jesus. And so now that the gospel of Jesus has reached the entire world, now is the time for the Jewish people to repent.
Okay, now, that's an interesting perspective, but look at this. When we look at the scripture, Jesus says, because those whom I chose rejected me, then I engrafted all nations unto me. So now we have to remember this. The scripture says that he's not Jew by the flesh. So now he has made a distinction that all are engrafted in by the Spirit.
Yes.
So now we all become one in the Spirit. So when we talk about that, and we talk about the spiritual unification that came through Jesus, yes, because this is something the scripture says, for God so loved the world that he gave Jesus for the world, not just for a particular type of people. So when we think about that, that God is a God that unifies.
That's
He's
right.
not a God who separates.
Yes.
How is that going to factor into what you're talking about when yes. making America great again?
Oh, okay. So we're still thinking about the Jewish people, okay? So because we are unified, but the Jewish people and the Muslim and the Arab people, they're not unified yet. These poor two groups, they have been fighting each other for thousands and thousands of years, and they are not unified yet. See? So, but how are they going to be unified? They are going to be unified when the Jewish people repent for having killed Jesus. And then the Arab people, when they read the Quran, you know, the Quran, I read the Quran after September 11, and it says the Jewish people need to repent for having killed Jesus, and the Christian people, they need to repent for regarding Jesus as God. Jesus is not God. God is not one of three. God is one. He could not understand the Trinity of God. So, but anyways, the first step is to get the Jewish people here in the United States. That's where the wonderful thing is. Right here in the United States, we help the Jewish people here to repent. And when they...
Wow.
Yes, right here. And then when they repent, the Arab people will have nothing to say. They reconcile. See, and then the blessings of Abraham in Genesis 12, 1 and 2, you read that.
Okay.
Abraham received the blessing, everyone, every seed that would come from him, it would be blessed.
Excellent. Okay. Let us do this. It's time for, let us take a break. Don't go anywhere. Keep watching. We're going to take a break, and we'll be right back to continue this very exciting talk and interview. Stay tuned.
Congratulations. You are the recipient of 7 nights of luxury resort accommodations. Choose from thousands of U.S. destinations and hundreds of international destinations. Have the time of your life. Redeem your certificate now and start planning your luxury vacation today. We contract with the world-leading hotel chains and resorts to help fill empty rooms, which the hotels, resorts, and cruise lines turn into additional revenue from other areas of their property and future bookings. you will receive 7 nights luxury resort accommodations. Redeem your certificate to activate your offer and start planning your vacation today. Candace from Greenville, South Carolina said, "Our vacation was absolutely amazing. The travel agency gave us the opportunity of a lifetime. We had the pleasure of getting married on our vacation we booked through them. Thank you." So what are you waiting for? Activate your offer today.
Well, welcome back. Listen, we're going to continue this exciting broadcast. So continue to talk to us. You've been sharing some exciting things. We're talking about unification. We're talking about the things that need to take place in the spirit, and that the spiritual significance of America being united and the world being united. Let's talk about the spiritual significance of that.
So we are in the United States of America. We have people from all the world. We have Chinese, Japanese, we have Russians, we have people from the Middle East, from Africa, from Europe. Everyone is here. And we can demonstrate to the rest of the world that we can get along with each other. Okay. So we need to stop all this bickering. Right now, all this bickering, the white people force, no, the black people force, the Chinese people, who never force. No one is forced. There has to be a leader when, you know, things happen. And it happened to be the white people. But the idea is that everyone participates, all groups participate in love and harmony in the United States of America to give an example to the rest of the world. Mm. Look, if we can get along here in this nation, the entire world, with the help of the Jewish God, the Creator, and with the help of the sacrificial blood of Jesus the Christ, all the world can be together and in love and harmony and participate in the
yes. And that's quite interesting. You know, when we look in Corinthians talks about God not being the author of confusion.
That's right.
And so when we look at that, God doesn't cause the confusion to come about. No. You know, but it's the fallen state of humanity that's caused confusion to come about.
That's right.
So now, when we say that God so loved the world, and I hear you speaking about the unification of the entire world, the unification of all people, yeah, where we cease to be that. Galatians says there's neither Jew nor Greek. So he doesn't talk about racial divide, but we're all one in Christ.
That's
when
right.
You hear that and thinking about your book, what would be some keys that you would say would help us to become unified and to become one in Christ?
Yes. First, we tell President Biden, thank you for qualifying us for our new mission. And then next year, we need to put President Trump so that he can continue to do what he was doing before, to put America first. Why do we have to put America first? It's because we, the entire world, we are like an airplane. You know, it's wobbling to where airplane is all wobbling. And so the title goes on there and says, put the masks, the oxygen masks, the adults first. And then you put the oxygen mask to the child. And we, in this tribulation, entire world tribulation, we, America, is the adult. And that's why we need to put America first. First, we fix what needs to be fixed here. And then we tell the nations, look to us, we fix that, you can fix it too.
Okay, now, but the world, now under the last administration, the world looked at America as being divided, because the world said under the last administration, not the present administration, that one people were given precedence over the other people. that everything wasn't level for all people in America. And that's when we saw all these different things breaking out. So the world did not look at America as being one under the last administration.
That's right.
Now, so the world has a view now of America being more united. It's not a political thing that America needs. It's a spiritual thing that America needs.
Yes. When President Trump came on the political scene, I sent him a copy of my book. In my book, I tell him we need to have a peace with the Russians. We need to make a peace with all the other nations. And President Trump started that. He had good relationships with Putin, good relationship with Kim Jong-un of North Korea and everybody else. But he was misunderstood. Why? Because he is the only one who wrote who read this book. So we need everyone to read this book.
Okay, but look at this.
That way we are all with the same mindset, and we will come together with President Trump. We're not going to stay here and watch the news, President Trump doing everything. No, we are going to be engaged with him and to make America strong and to help the Jewish people repent and to help the Jewish and Arab people to come to reconcile right here in the United States of America. And then when they reconcile here, and then Jerusalem is going to say, people in Israel and Jerusalem, they're going to say, well, look at that. That nation was so mixed up, and that nation is doing so good now. Maybe we need to do what they have been doing.
But
so
how do you resolve this view? The world sees America as being racist. The world sees America as preferring one race of people over another. That means that America was not united under the past administration. So now, and those were the things that the world sees America for. So when we talk about uniting America, we have to unite America before we can talk about uniting the world. Now, under the last administration, we saw a group of people giving preference over another group of people.
Well, now we have to start this new mindset that we are all together, and I'm asking for all these groups to come together in love and harmony under the leadership of Jesus the Christ.
Because that's the key.
Yes.
It's not a person.
No.
It's not an individual.
No.
The way that it will be united is under the leadership of Jesus Christ. It's not a political thing. It's a spiritual thing.
Yes. Oh, bravo, doctor. You are so intelligent.
You're so intelligent.
Yes, you are.
Thank you.
You are so intelligent and so understanding. And so I hope our audience accepts the fact that we need to stop bickering.
Oh.
Here in the United States, stop all the bickering. Over here, we are one nation under God and under the leadership of Jesus the Christ. And now, from now on, we'll come together in love and harmony, and we are going to do what Jesus did. We heal the sick. We fed the hungry. We feed the
yes.
hungry. We instruct the ignorant, and we comfort the afflicted.
Yes.
We do all those four things. And so when we do those four things, we become the prototype of the kingdom of God. And Jerusalem and in Israel, they will accept Jesus, and that's when they will pick the leadership of the kingdom of God, and 144,000 of priests will be proclaimed in Israel.
Wow.
See?
This is so exciting. You know, it's so exciting Because when we come together and unify in the spirit, where there's no division, there's no separation, but we begin to love the way that God, Jesus, Holy Spirit loves. For God so loved the world that he gave Jesus for the world. That is powerful. So yes, you are so correct. When we come together in spirit,
that's
and
right.
stop being divided, then we're going to see that restoration and that unification that God desires. Listen, we have, take some time, because we have just a couple of minutes left. Take the time now to give your website and to give our audience information as to how they can contact you.
Oh, okay. The way they can contact me, they can go to my website, which is www.newvision-usa.com.
Okay, give them that again. Give them that one more time.
www.newvision-usa.com.
Okay. Give them your name and where they can get your books.
My book, they can go to that website, and there is a way to order my book there. And then there is pretty soon at Amazon.com. Right now, Amazon has the older version, but I have added some paragraphs at the end, extra episodes to help President Biden. Because while President Biden is at the White House, he can still do something for God. And then we can send them away, making him feel good that he has done all this. He has demonstrated to the entire world that America is not selfish. And even if we cannot...
Okay, we have just 30 minutes, just 30 seconds left. Thank you so much. And that's our time today for Books of the Month. I tell you, it's been exciting. We thank you all for joining in. Remember, take the information, go to the website, order the book. Thank you so much for being our guest today.
Thank you for this wonderful opportunity, and thank you for letting me meet you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.